In today's video, I will show you how to make this great pinwheel effect granny square. You can use any color that you like, any type of yarn that you like. Just understand that the different yarn you use is going to dictate what size your actual finished granny square is going to be. So, for example, this is made with a size 2 or fine yarn. And this right here was actually made with a worsted weight size 4 yarn. You can see the difference. And of course, keep in mind, I put a couple of extra borders or rounds on the larger piece, but in effect, you really kind of have this size compared to, oh, this size, right? So that gives you some kind of context in which to decide how you're going to use this and what different effects you're going to get using the different colored yarns. For example, you can go much more simply than this and make the colors like maybe a taupe and a light beige. And that'll give it a nice subtle, maybe beachy look. Or you can do a black and white. And that'll give it a more, oh, I don't know, more stripey look, like animal print look. There's really kind of different ways you can go with this. It really just depends on the yarn you use and the color you choose to use. But the effect is so much fun. So my name is Sig, and it is a complete pleasure to have you with me at this time. It's your support that allows me to contribute new content and weekly videos. Help us grow together by tapping the subscribe bar, notification bell, and like buttons. I look forward to your comments and always value your feedback. Let's get started. Okay, so now that we're back, I'm going to use this black thread. It's unbranded, but I know it's cotton. And then I'm going to also use this recycled silk yarn. It's called Autumn Jubilee, and the company that distributes this particular yarn is put out by Darn Good Yarn, and this is a size 2 yarn. It's a fine size. I'm also going to be using a 2.2 millimeter hook for this, and we're going to get started with the black. And so for the black, I'm going to go ahead and I am going to make an adjustable ring. And then for row 1, I want 8 single crochets. Three, four, five, six, seven, and 8. I'm going to go ahead and tighten up my ring. And then I'm going to join. And I'm going to make a chain. And then for row 2, I want to do 2 single crochets in each of the stitches from row 1. So I had a total of 8 stitches in row 1, and row 2, when I'm finished, I will have a total of 16 single crochets. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Then we're going to join this together with a slip stitch. And then I'm going to also change colors at this point. So we'll fasten off. and I will begin row 3. So we've started our next color. I'm going to chain 3, and that's going to act as my first double crochet in this row. My next stitch is going to be a half double crochet, a single crochet, next stitch, and then a half double crochet in the following stitch. So that gives me my chain 3, which acts as my double crochet, my half double crochet, my single crochet, and my half double crochet. And then I'm going to begin again with my double crochet to start this pattern all over again. And we're going to do that 3 more times. So it's going to be the double crochet, and then the half double crochet, and then the single crochet, and then a half double crochet. And we're going to do the double crochet. And then a half double crochet. A single crochet. And then a half double crochet. And then one more time, we got the double crochet, half double crochet, single crochet, half double crochet, and then we're going to join. And we're going to finish off that round of color. So as you can see, I'm also weaving in my ends as I work. I would just prefer to do that. You can certainly weave them in later, but I like to weave them in as I move along. So now, with row 4, we're going to start kind of where we finished. And I'm going to get started. And then in that same spot, I'm going to do a single crochet. And then my next stitch is going to be a half double crochet. And then after that will be a double crochet. And then a treble crochet will be my next stitch. And then I'm going to chain 4. And this will be the pattern that we will follow 3 more times. So I'm going to do a single crochet in my next stitch. And then a half double crochet, and then a double crochet, and then a treble crochet, and then I'm going to chain 4. And then again, single crochet, half double crochet, a double crochet, treble crochet, and then chain 4. Single, half double, double, treble, and then chain 4. And then I'm going to slip stitch, join with a slip stitch, and then finish off this row. So this is what you should have so far. And we're going to move to our color again. And this time, rather than starting here, we are going to start here at the beginning of this chain four. All right, then I'll show you what I mean. So in this chain four, I'm going to begin to single crochet once, single crochet twice, and then two half double crochets in this chain four space. And then I'm going to the next stitch is going to be a double crochet. And then another double crochet in the next stitch. And then a treble crochet. And then another treble crochet in the following stitch. And then I'm going to chain four. Okay. So this is what you should look like so far. Okay, so keep in mind your first round is going to have 8 stitches. Your second round is going to have 16 stitches. Your third round is going to have 16 stitches. Your fourth round is going to have 32 stitches. And then this fifth round that we're working right now will end up having 48 stitches. So now that we've completed our four chain, we're going to go into this next chain four space and make two single crochets plus two half double crochets. And then in the following stitch is going to be that double crochet, and then another double crochet, and then a treble crochet, and another treble crochet, and a chain four. And then we'll go ahead and we will single crochet 2 times in that chain four space. Plus we will also put 2 half double crochets in that chain four space. And then the next 2 stitches will be double crochets. And then the next 2 stitches after that will be treble crochets. And then chain four, and then again, 2 single crochets in that chain four space, and then 2 half double crochets, and then in the next stitch, a double crochet, another double crochet following that. And then in those last 2 stitches, you want a treble crochet. And then chain four. And then I will join into that very first single crochet of row 5. And we will tie off. Okay, so now you can really start getting a feel for where this spiral or this pinwheel look is beginning to happen. It's beginning to take some shape. Okay, so now we're going to switch back over to the black. For row 6. And I'm going to begin again in the chain 4 space. And I'm going to do 3 single crochets. And 1/2 double crochet in the chain 4 space. And then in the next stitch, I'm going to do a 1/2 double crochet once, a 1/2 double crochet twice. So that'll have me with a total of 3 double crochets. So 3 single crochets and 1 double crochet in the chain 4 space. And then the next 2 stitches will have double crochets. And then I'll do a double crochet in the next 3 stitches. And then I will have a treble crochet in the next 3 stitches. Okay, so just a quick recap. We are going to have 3 single crochets plus a 1/2 double crochet in this chain 4 space. Then we're going to have a 1/2 double crochet and then another 1/2 double crochet. Then we're going to have 3 double crochets. In addition, we are going to have 3 treble crochets. Then we'll chain 4. And start that pattern all over again. So, 1 2, 3 single crochets, and a 1/2 double crochet. Then a 1/2 double crochet. And another 1/2 double crochet. Maybe. There we go. And then I want, in the next 3 stitches, 3 double crochets. And then in the next 3 stitches, a treble crochet in each. And then chain 4. Single, 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 1/2 double, 1/2 double, 1/2 double, and double, double, and a double, and then a treble. And a treble. And a treble. And we're going to chain 4. and then one more time. And then we're going to, after we do our four chain, we're going to go ahead and fasten off onto the very first single crochet of row six. So this is what I have so far. And you should have something that looks similar. And then row six, you should have a count of 64 stitches all the way around by this point. So for row seven, same thing. We're going to begin over here in the chain four space. And as before, we're going to start off with our single crochet. But this time we're going to have four single crochets in that chain four space. And then in the next four stitches, we are going to put a half double crochet in the next four stitches. And then in the next four stitches after that, we're going to put double crochet. And then in the next four stitches after that, we're going to put a treble crochet. And then chain four. And then start that all over again. So, four single crochets in the chain four space. And then a half double crochet in the next four stitches. Then a double crochet in the next four stitches after that. And then in the next four stitches after those, treble crochet. And then chain four. And then again. 4 singles. Four half doubles. And then chain your 4, and then of course join with a slip stitch back at that very first single crochet. And we're going to fasten this off and get ready to change the color to black. So your row 7 should have 80 stitches all the way around. And again with your row 8. I'm going to begin with 4 single crochets in this space. So I'll start with a slip stitch and then my 4 single crochets. And then my next 6 stitches, I am going to put in half double crochets. And then the next 5 stitches, I will have a double crochet. Thank you. And then the next 5 stitches after that will be treble crochets. Again, we're going to have chain 4. And then the 4 single crochets in that chain 4 space. And then a half double crochet in the next 6 spaces. And then a double crochet in the next 5 spaces, or next 5 stitches. And then in the last 5 stitches, treble crochet. And then a chain 4. Then we'll begin it all over again 2 more times on each side of the row. I'll see you right back here in just a couple of minutes. And finish off. So of course you're probably going to want to block this, depending on what it is you're going to do with it. You can add these together to mini blocks and come up with all sorts of different designs and different patterns. Or you can continue and make it one big giant one, like what you saw previously. And then that size pretty much came as a result of just using your standard worsted weight yarn. So this size, if I just put a border on it, it would really make a great little coaster. Put a little extra border on and around it, and that would work out just great. So again, I'd like to remind you to follow, subscribe, like, comment, all these good things that help push the algorithm in a way that allows me to grow this content. With all that said, until we get meet again, I'd just like to say to all you wonderful fiber artists, stay safe. Stay amazing, and above all, stay crafty.